Hi, it's John Davies here with another business boosting tip for you. Today I want to talk about 5 tips to have a successful business in 2015. I was at a conference recently and some of the speakers had really successful multi-million pound businesses, and what became apparent is that they actually shared 5 common characteristics, so I'm going to talk about them. So, the first one is they all have automated lead generation systems. These are things that keep leads coming in, potentially sales coming through, automatically 24 hours a day. So what kind of things can these include? Well, there are things like, if you look at us, we're not quite a multi-million pound business yet. But even for someone like us, we have things like opt-in forms on our websites. We have email marketing. We have lead magnets, things you can kind of download, say ebooks and the likes, which give us your details and let us then contact you later. We have things like this, the videos, social media, and a lot of the people at this conference obviously took these to kind of, you know, the nth degree, but it is a very common characteristic of super successful businesses is actually to have the rhythmic acquisition of customers at all times. Okay. The second thing that these businesses all had in common was continuity. They have continuity programs. So once they found you as a customer, which is actually often the hardest thing, is getting the customer through the door for the first time, they actually have a way of actually getting you to buy again and again, and generally wherever possible on a monthly cycle. I mean, we're accountants, so most of our clients are therefore annual fees, and we most of them actually pay monthly. What it means is we know there are fees coming in each month from our customers. But this can actually work for most businesses. If you think about the amount of places where you can actually buy kind of the monthly passes, say to the gym, the cinema will have a monthly pass. Things actually therefore mean that they actually know the money's coming on the first of the month. And it generally can work across lots of businesses where things like hairdressers who do it, where may have a VIP program, for example, where you pay an amount every month that allows you to get your hair cut as often as you want. Okay. The third thing that all these people had in common was premium products and prices. A favourite of ours, this is where you have your normal product and then you make it better. And that can be quicker, bigger, smaller, better quality, whatever it may be. But actually gets, again, you've got your customer in already, they like you and they might buy a better version of your product. I mean, a very obvious example would be on the trains, first class. It's a great version of a premium product. I've talked previously about onions, where you can actually buy ready diced onions with quite a large markup, but people are willing to pay that for convenience. And again, you can find one of these in pretty much every business. Okay. Fourth thing these had in common was multimedia marketing. They don't just rely on one form of marketing. So they will have a combination of things. They'll have adverts. They'll have used the internet, many of them will use the internet because that also works 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. But then they'll keep mixing things up and use an array of things. One of the ones as well is kind of direct mail. A lot of people actually ignore that these days and think everything's on the internet. But actually that means actually you do get a lot less posts through your door. And if you look at this, even Google, we get letters quite often from Google advertising their product, Google AdWords. Now, if probably the largest online thing in the world uses the post, it's probably a decent tip to the rest of us, it's still worth using. And one way of actually really getting people's attention with direct mail is to send lumpy mail. So it's not just junk mail, but it's something that actually catches their eye. Just in the last few weeks, I've received a couple of things, actually came from the same people. I received this stress ball. And as you can imagine, when that comes in an envelope, it does stick out. It's not just a boring envelope. The stress ball was in there, and their product is offered to take away the stress. And then also, I actually received these handcuffs. These handcuffs were sent to me all the way from the States as well. So, you know, it must be kind of worth something for the product they were selling. And actually selling was a conference that was $1,000 called Escape. And its handcuffs was a handy little tie-in to that. But again, it caught my attention when it came through the door. Okay, so that's kind of just mixing up your marketing across the different kind of media that are out there. And the fifth one that was really common was all these people, all the business owners, had kind of mentors and peer groups. It's kind of often said that Richard Branson has a number of mentors. He can't do it all by himself, and he actually, you know, welcomes actually having people to bounce ideas off. I mean, we our firm, we have a business coach, because as much as we coach some of our clients, sometimes you need some external to help you with your business, and some peer groups as well, because who you hang around with does kind of matter quite a lot. If you hang around with successful people with good ideas, you bounce off each other. I think the analogy quite often is if you play golf, if you play with good people, you'll play well. If you play with bad people, you play badly. So actually who you hang around with and having those kind of mentors and a good peer group to bounce ideas off is really, really useful in a business. So those five tips again. The first one was to have automated lead generation, an automatic way of bringing customers in. Okay. Second one was continuity, something that gets your customers paying you month to month. Third was premium products. You know, you have your product and have a better version of it. Okay. The fourth was just mixing up your marketing, so using as many different types as possible. And the fifth was who you hang around with matters a lot. Okay. So if you've got any queries about any of those, any comments, please leave them below. I'd love you to get in touch on either the phone number or the email below. And I'll be back soon with another business boosting tip for you. Thank you.